Welcome back to Crack the QR series with me, Kaveh Tendral. Today we'll see about the medical entomology, the continuation of before parts. This is part 3A. It is all about the identification of the mosquitoes. If you have not subscribed to our channel, do subscribe for more interesting videos like this. And as well, don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will receive a daily video notification. In this video, we'll see about the classification of arthropods and the four important stages in life cycle of a mosquito, that is egg, larva, pupa and adult mosquito identification, the breeding place, flying distance and time of mosquito bite, this is spread by the mosquitoes. Coming to the classification, basically the phylum Arthropoda is classified into class Insecta, Arachnida, Crustata, and the Insecta we classify in turn with wings and without wings. Under with wings we have flies, reduid bug and mosquito. Now our topic of interest is the mosquitoes. Under mosquitoes we are classifying under into two important categories, that is Anopheles and Culicinensis. In Anopheles it is Anopheles mosquito and Culicinensis it is Aedes, Culex and Mansonia, and these are some of the examples of the mosquitoes given below. With this very basic data, let us go on to solving the pictures. These are all the eggs of the mosquitoes. It is the Anopheles egg that has lateral floats. To remember, L for lateral on both the side, that is E. So it means on both the side it is present, something is present similarly on both the sides, that is lateral folds. Even Culex has L, but Culex doesn't have E on both sides. Okay, so Anopheles X has lateral floats and it is boat shaped. Coming to Aedes, it doesn't have lateral floats, and another important thing, it is cigar shaped. Culex X are usually laid in clusters, that too it is like shape of raft, so it's a raft shaped cluster. Here also there is no lateral folds. So remember again, Culex, C-U-L, so jumble L before so that it will become cluster. So clustered egg is usually Culex, it is not Aedes and Anopheles. Next, coming to the larval stage, before we actually see the pictures of larval stage, one important thing to remember, that is in Anopheles they doesn't possess siphon tube, whereas in Aedes, Culex and Mansonia possess siphon tube. That too, the siphon tube of Mansonia is attached to the rootlets of Pistia plant, which is really more important, whereas in case of Aedes and Culex they have siphon tube, of which Culex has long siphon tube. This is the pictorial representation of the larva in the water. One important thing is the Anopheles hatch, Anopheles has hatched. So remember, like Anopheles larva will be present on the horizontal lie or parallel to the surface of water, which is really more important because that doesn't have siphon tube. Thereby it is present in the surface, it is a surface feeder. With this basic data, let us now see the image. Here in this picture, the Anopheles larva is horizontal in like this view. Is basically from the superior we are seeing, that is it is in the most horizontally present parallel to the surface, and this is in the surface feeder Anopheles larva. Culex larva has a large siphon tube, so they can be adhering to the surface and can also swim inside. Aedes larva also has the siphon tube. The larva is a free swimming creature with an elongated body, and it usually feeds on the algae, bacteria and vegetable matter. This pass through a four stage of growth called as instars, with a molting on each stages. Thereby all these will swim freely in water. In this picture we can identify that in the abdomen that this larva has a siphon tube. Again, this larva has a siphon tube. In the middle it doesn't have siphon tube, and that by we say it is an Anopheles larva. The siphon tube in the Culex is longer. Next, coming to the pupa form. In the pupa form, the Anopheles pupa take P from Anopheles. It is like a pyramid. Pyramid is triangular. So thereby the Anopheles pupa has a broad, stout and triangular siphon tube. In Culican pupa, L, so it is narrow, longer, L and tube-like. Next, coming to the mosquitoes. First, we'll see the breeding site and time of bite, and then we'll go for identification. First is Culex. Culex, in Tamil, we say kutta. Kutta. So it is usually a dirty water. So dirty water and lex. Like, it is similar to relax. When we relax, it is when we sleep. That is, especially in the midnight, we'll be sleeping with relaxed. So in the midnight, what is going to bite is this Culex, and it is breeding on the dirty water. Next, coming to Anopheles. PH gives a pronunciation of F. So that is a freshwater breeding in is done by Anopheles. And usually the evening time or the early night bite is by the Anopheles mosquito. Then coming to day bite. Aedes has D. So thereby it is a day. Aedes is a day biter. And as well, it breeds in artificially collected water, especially after raining. That is the coconut shell, the tires and plastics, etc. That is Aedes. Next, coming to Mansonia uniformis. Mansonia, usually we know, we have seen that this larval form of Mansonia will stick on to the rootlet of the Pistia plant, and thereby wherever the pond and lake with Pistia plant and plant like hydrilla, that place is where the Mansonia will breed. Usually it bites at night. Culex and Mansonia usually cause filariasis, and thereby the mosquitoes causing filariasis usually bite at night, and thereby Mansonia and Culex are biting at night, especially Culex at midnight. Next, coming to the like acronym, like for Anopheles mosquito alone. For Anopheles mosquito, we'll take AN. For AN, it is laying only one egg. That is, singly it is laying an egg, 1111. And next is, it is angulated. AN for angulated, of 45 degree inclination when it is at rest on the surface. That is the adult. Next is NO. For NO, it is no siphon tube in larval stage, but there is a short triangular siphon tube in the pupa. Next is no buzzing sound, very important, because Culex is prone for giving this buzzing sound, whereas in Anopheles, no. Next is NOPH, that is no phlegm. So this phlegm is given, just to give for example, it is a contaminant. Phlegm is a contaminant, right? So it will breed in no phlegm area, that is a clean water, that is fresh water. And also for EL, egg as lateral float. Next, coming to this diagram, this basically gives just to identify the mosquitoes only. We'll now take the criteria of the wing. In case of an Anopheles mosquito, the wing is spotted like this. In case of a Aedes mosquito, the wing is not spotted, whereas the body is spotted. In case of a Culex mosquito, it is the strongest wing. So because of this strong wing, it can fly up to 11 kilometers. Next, coming to Mansonia. Mansonia, the wing and the legs are speckled based on the wings. Anopheles is spotted. Aedes is not spotted, but the body is spotted. Black body with white spot. In Culex, it is the strongest wing and thereby it can fly for 11 kilometers. Mansonia, that a wing and the legs are speckled. With that idea, we come back to identify the mosquito. Here in Aedes, the black body with white spot we are seeing. In Culex, the leg and the wing is speckled in Mansonia, spotted wing in Anopheles, strong wing, but we cannot see the strong wing, rather we can see the short palpi in the Culex mosquito. Now we will see the disease caused by these mosquitoes. Anopheles cause malaria. To remember, we know malaria is basically Plasmodium species. So P4P, Plasmodium malaria. Culex, it is the Utcheria bancrofti causes bancroftian filariasis. So C is there, and as well XYW. So X and W are similar. So Utcheria is transmitted by Culex. Next is Culex will be seen in Kutta, in some disease, right? Kutta, Kutta la we have pigs. Pigs and this Culex together cause an important disease called Japanese encephalitis. Other diseases are West Nile fever and viral arthritis. Coming to Aedes, D4D again is dengue and chikungunya. Dengue, chikungunya, as well yellow fever, but it is not present in India. Next, coming to Mansonia. Mansonia causes malarian filariasis, which is caused by Brugia malai, sheath microfilaria, similar to Utcheria bancrofti. Thank you so much for your patient listening.